In this video, I'm gonna show how to generate a server-side rendering page with Thymeleaf and Spring Boot. I'm gonna show how to generate a dynamic web page with Thymeleaf, with images, style, fragments, and control of the language. There are many types of frontends, but today we will see the difference between the server-side frontend and the client-side frontend. The client-side frontend is when the resulting HTML is created in the client, in the browser. Frontend applications like Angular or React are written using mainly JavaScript. The browser receives JavaScript with pieces of HTML and CSS, and its job is to build the resulting HTML. On the other side, I have the server-side frontends. This time, the backend is the one which generates the resulting HTML. The backend can send static HTML pages, or it can generate them with templating frameworks like Thymeleaf. So let's generate a website with Spring Boot and Thymeleaf. But first, remember to subscribe to my channel. Let's start by creating a Spring Boot project. For this, I will use Spring Initializer. I change the group, Sergio. Thymeleaf, the artifact, backend, the name, backend, the latest version of Spring Boot, a Maven project, the Java language, a jar packaging, and the Java version 17. I will add some dependencies. Web and Thymeleaf. Let's now download and open it with IntelliJ. Let's start by creating an endpoint to return my HTML page. I create a new package, controllers, and then the controller, home controller. I add the controller annotation and my endpoint, get mapping on root, return a string, and the name of the HTML page, index. Let's start by a simple HTML page. In the resources folder, I put the Thymeleaf template in the templates folder. Index.html. I start adding the doc type. This line defines the namespace used by Thymeleaf. Every time I start an HTML tag with th, it belongs to a Thymeleaf instruction. Let's add a head with some metadata. And the title. My Spring Boot app. I continue with the body, create a header, but I leave it empty for now. And now a section with a title, learn Spring Boot like in real life projects, with a link, a href. https Sergio Lema Spring Boot Academy target blank more details and add a footer with just my name Sergio Lema. Let's start this now. Here is the resulting HTML page at localhost 8080. I have the title, the link, and the footer. Let's now include some CSS and some images. First, I include the CSS file. I link a relation style sheet, which is under styles.css. I create this file, styles CSS and add an image. Th class logo source logo png alt logo image. As said, when starting with th, it belongs to Thymeleaf. This time I only indicate the class to use. There is no logic in there. I could have used class directly, but this is the first example. And I will add another image here. Th class cover with the source at image.jpg alt academy. And in the footer, I will change the class of my name. Light text. Let's edit the CSS. I have the logo class, cover class, the light text class, and I will add some padding to the section and footer. Padding left 200 pixels. For the logo, I will limit the width 80%. For the cover, I will limit the width to 50%. Padding top 100 pixels and padding bottom 100 pixels. And in the light text, color gray. And let's include the images in the static folder. Let's test this all again. Okay, here is the logo, the title remains there. I have the image, the link and the footer, which is gray now. Until here, there is nothing really dynamic. Let's now inject a list into the template and iterate over it. Let's go to the home controller and add the model. Model add. Attribute. Features. An array list. With working in projects. With an experienced mentor. Getting real feedback from your work. Learn some best practices about software design. That's it. Let's go to the HTML. Include another title, H3, what you will find in the academy, unlimited list, th each with item of features, and inside a list item, th text with item. The each tag reads the list of elements from the variable features. I can read the values of the variables with the dollar sign and the curly brackets. Then each element will be stored in a variable item at each iteration. It's a for loop, and inside the for, I use the item variable in the text tag. Now I see the new title and the list of items created with the for loop. I've used one of the most basic operations in programming, the for loop. Let's continue with another one, the if condition. Let's go again to the controller. I add a request parameter with the name show details boolean show details. Not required, and store it in the model.
add attribute, show details. Let's go to the HTML now to use it. I will display all this content depending on the value show details. Div th if show details. Inside the if condition, I've used the boolean show details, but I could have used a more complicated if condition with and ors. I also have the unless, which renders what's inside only if the condition is false. By default, the details are not shown. If I add the value in the URL, show details equals true, I have now the details displayed.
I will show two more features of Thymeleaf, the fragments and the localization of the messages. The fragments allow me to include pieces of templates in my page, and the localization is to display a message in different languages. Let's start with the fragments.
I create the fragments in a new folder. Inside the templates, I create fragments. And inside, I create my file, details.html. As before, I start with the .type. Let's copy the namespace and start with the body. Fragment, I name it content with a variable length. This is the name of my fragment as a method with input variables. When requesting a fragment, what will be used is what's inside. I add a title, th if lang is equal to English, what you will find in the academy. If it's Spanish, encontrarás en la academia. And now the unlimited list as before. Th each item of features and the list items th text item. Let's now go to the index.html to use this fragment. Remove all div th replace. I choose a fragment details HTML with content as English. And to use it, I call replace with the path of the fragment, the method name, and the value of the input parameter. The result is the same as before, but now this content comes from the fragment file.
Last part is the localization of a message. I can display the content of my web page depending on the local I send. The local is a text sent in the header accept language, and the value is composed of two main parts, the language and the country. The first part indicates the language and the second part indicates the country, because the same language can be different depending on the country. It's the case of the English from the USA and the English from England, but the country is optional. In my case, I will only use the language part. To intercept the HTTP header and use it in my template, I need to add a configuration. For this, I create a new package, config, and inside I add my configuration class, local config, with the configuration annotation, public local change interceptor. LCI new local change interceptor. I set the parameter name, which is link for language, and return it. I declare the bin public web MVC
configure. And implement only the method to add an interceptor. Registering, add interceptor, the local change interceptor, nothing more. Let's go now to the indexed HTML. I will change the title to be dynamic. Text from page title. I remove it. The h2 text from page subtitle. Remove the text. And now I create in the resources a new file. Messages, properties. I declare the page title and the page subtitle as my Spring Boot Academy and the subtitle Earn Spring Boot Like in Real Life Projects. I will add another messages property for Spanish. Messages underscore ES properties. With the same definitions, page title and page subtitle. Mi Academia Spring Boot Aprende Spring Boot con proyectos reales. I have two bundle files, the Spanish one and the default one. When receiving the Spanish local, Thymeleaf will use the Spanish bundle file. When receiving another local, it uses the default one. This is a hierarchy in the locals. Let's say I receive a local of English from UK. If I have a bundle file of English from UK, Thymeleaf will use it. If not, it looks for an English bundle file. And if not, it uses the default bundle file. To include the header, I will use it from a terminal. Curl localhost 8080 accept language English. And here is the content with my title in English and the subtitle in English too. And now, if I change the language to Spanish, I have the title and the subtitle in Spanish. Let's make a quick recap. I've created a Spring Boot application with the dependencies Web and Thymeleaf. I've created a controller with the model and returning the name of the HTML file. I've created the HTML file under templates. I've used th-each and th-text for the for loop. I've used th-if for the if condition. I've created a fragment under the fragments folder and used it with th-fragment and th-replace. For the localization, I've created the local config and created the messages bundles for different languages. That's all for this video. I hope you liked it and you learned something new. Remember to subscribe to my channel, click on the like button, and see you soon. Bye!